The three ways to quickly lower blood sugar. In this video, I'm going to teach you three ways to have the best control of diabetes, of blood sugar levels. You may already be tired of false promises and miraculous products to control diabetes. This video here is not about that. I will use scientific evidence along with my experience. I'm an endocrinologist. I've been treating diabetes patients for more than 10 years, so I know what really works to help you with this control. Just promise me you won't stop any treatment your doctor prescribed just because you're going to follow the tips in this video, okay? Keep up with your treatment. Always talk to your doctor before stopping or starting any other medication as it can be hazardous. Remember, quickly lowering glucose is not the same as controlling diabetes. Quickly lowering means you'll have the best control on that day. But controlling diabetes yields good results for weeks, even months. One test we use to assess diabetes control and treatment is glycated hemoglobin. This test measures the average blood sugar over the last 90 to 120 days. So there's a difference. Often, in some videos, they use this to mislead you, discussing diabetes control when it's really about controlling blood sugar levels, as it's a quick result. So, how can you improve your blood glucose levels? The first way is through hydration, fluid intake, and water intake. For a long time, over the years, in the hospital emergency room, I've seen that many patients who came in with high blood sugar levels were actually dehydrated, most of them, in fact. Why does this happen? How can you prevent it? What is the right amount of water you should drink? This happens for two reasons. The first is our body's defense mechanism. When blood sugar increases to try to defend itself and counteract that, our kidneys start to eliminate sugar, they start to eradicate glucose. And you also have a higher tendency to get dehydrated because the blood can become a bit more concentrated and proportionally there will be more sugar there, which worsens the situation. That's why one of the immediate measures is to correct the hydration issue. So much so that you may have heard that one of the signs that sugar is too high is ants in the bathroom because sweet urine with glucose can attract ants. That's true, that's not a myth. So much so that the origin of the word diabetes, look how interesting, diabetes mellitus in Greek, diabetes means siphon because the patient urinates a lot of water. Now it makes sense. And if you stay hydrated, you can fix it quickly. And how are you going to fix it? What is the ideal amount of water you should drink every day? There's a calculation we can use to approximate this amount, which is your weight multiplied by 30. In the case of 3,000 milliliters, or 3 liters, this is divided throughout the day. I'll add a note here that this recommendation could be a little lower if you have renal failure, especially in advanced stages, when the kidneys can't function properly, or if you're receiving hemodialysis, this can be altered. So in these cases, it's worth questioning your doctor if you have reduced kidney function, all right? Because this will not always be favorable, but generally speaking, if you don't have any kidney issue, this calculation will be very helpful, and quickly you'll be able to have a lower blood sugar level through this mechanism I've explained. That's why there's this notion that certain teas are good for diabetes control. No tea actually has strong scientific proof that it can reduce blood sugar levels. But many people have this idea, this impression. Why? When they start drinking more tea, they also improve hydration, which we've seen is the first step to lowering blood sugar levels. So a patient who was dehydrated, had higher glucose levels due to more concentrated blood, was already undergoing this compensatory mechanism by the kidneys. When they start to hydrate more, start to drink this, in quotes, tea that works for diabetes, they end up improving the situation, but not because of the tea, but rather by the hydration levels. That's why so many myths end up arising. Now you're starting to understand. So these teas that promise a diabetes cure or quick control, they don't work, but if the patient is dehydrated, he might get that idea because it improves hydration levels. So it's very important. How much water do you drink per day? Write it down in the comments and stay tuned to this. It's a simple measure that doesn't cost money or your time. Just drink a little more water and you'll see the result in your blood sugar levels. The second way to quickly lower blood sugar levels is through physical activity. When I talk about physical activity, I mean light exercise right after meals. For instance, you've seen that your blood sugar rises more after lunch. So about 10, 15 minutes later, you perform some light physical activity. And how do you know that the physical activity is light? There are two ways. The first one is by calculation. If you have a watch that can measure your heart rate, it'll help you. Otherwise, I'll tell you another simpler way also. It's a calculation we do that's 220 minus your age multiplied by 0.55. This number will give you the heart rate for an activity that will help you in this process. So in my case here, just to give you an idea, it's going to be around 100 to 110 beats. Of course, it can't be an intense workout if you've just eaten. So a walk would already help you in this process of lowering blood sugar levels. Why? Our muscles end up taking the sugar in the blood and using it as a form of energy. And if your levels are high, your muscles can pick up on that to use in this process of lowering blood sugar. And the other simpler and more practical way for you to know the intensity is through some signals. And I'm going to use here the speech sign, which is very easy for you to notice. What would be an intense physical exercise by this rule of speech? It's the one you can't talk about even in small sentences. Moderate exercise is one where you can speak in short sentences, but you get uncomfortable. Light physical exercise, which is what I suggest you do, is the one you can talk while doing. So walking would be an option because you can talk and you can maintain a dialogue while walking. If you're having trouble, slow down a little bit. There's a study that discussed the duration of this exercise. About 10 minutes of walking after lunch, for example. And patients have already been able to reduce their blood sugar levels. I saw in another video that you were saying the best exercise was resistance exercise, like at the gym or with weights. That's true. In the long term, there's scientific evidence that resistance exercise with weights, swimming, and so on is better. These exercises are most beneficial for long-term control. But remember, we're talking short-term here. The purpose of this video is different, and you shouldn't head to the gym after lunch because it can be harmful for your health. Thirdly, the fastest way to get the best control of your blood sugar levels is by regulating your diet by doing two things. Watch the amount of simple carbohydrates, sugars like pasta, cake, bread, and flour, as well as sugar. That added sugar, sweetened drinks, chocolate drinks, fruit juices, whole juices like orange juice and grape juice, for example. So controlling the amount of sugar you eat with each meal, because this sugar will be metabolized and your blood sugar levels will rise. So control that if you already want the best short-term results. Also, add fiber to your meal. A really easy way for you to increase the amount of fiber is by adding chia, adding flaxseed. Why? These foods will lower the glycemic index of each meal. For instance, if you have a piece of fruit, sprinkle a bit of chia on it because the fibers will aid digestion, they will slow down the digestion, they will reduce the glycemic index, and you will feel more satisfied. So, in the short term, if you add fiber and also watch the carbohydrates you're consuming at each meal, this is already a pretty convenient method to decrease blood sugar levels soon. Remember, this doesn't mean diabetes has been controlled. Watch out. It implies that you will have the best control at that moment, which is very important also to cheer you up, to give you a breather so you can keep carrying out the many other steps to enhance blood sugar levels, and then indeed experience a decrease in glycated hemoglobin levels. On a scale of 0 to 10, what rating do you give this video? If it's 10, I'll make more videos like this. Also, let me know which city and part of the world you're watching this video from. I'm from Porto Alegre. Now I'm going to suggest a video for you to watch where I talk about coffee. Coffee contains substances that have been extensively studied for their potential effects on various diseases. One of them is diabetes. Want to know more about coffee? Check out the video here. If you enjoyed this video, you'll also want to learn more about coffee and all its health benefits. Click here to watch. Thanks for watching and see you next time.